Precision Boost Overdrive, AMD's latest feature on its latest Ryzen 3000 series processors. But is it something which really works, or is it just another marketing term used by the AMD for the Ryzen 3000 series? Let's find out. I think it is really tough to get your hands on a 3900X, and I want to thank Mech Peripherals who helped me buy it instantly at a fair price. I'll post their Facebook link in the description below. I will still say it is too early to benchmark the Ryzen 3000 processor because as time goes by, the BIOS updates are coming in, the chipset updates are coming in. I made sure to update my BIOS and chipset to the latest versions, whatever were available. But there are always some early adopters like me. I wanted to upgrade my system after many years and I couldn't wait more than what I already did because I knew that if I wait for a few more months, I would again wait for the next Ryzen which will come in 2020. So I wanted to upgrade it. I've already started doing productive work on it because I'm a 3D designer and I do a lot of rendering. So I am utilizing all these cores on the processor. So AMD is clearly promoting these processors with this feature they introduced on the Threadripper of the second gen Ryzen. And that is Precision Boost Overdrive, and I wanted to see how good is it, how good or different it is to the auto overclocking feature which many different motherboard vendors put out there on the motherboards. So I'm currently running the processor with its stock cooler, the Wraith Prism cooler which AMD provides. It's a really nice cooler, it looks really good, and it increases the value for money proposition of all these processors, the Ryzen 3000 generation, especially the 3700X and the 3900X. It comes with it, so it becomes an overall a great value, great investment for the price to performance ratio and for this cooler which AMD is providing. Here is the setup I'm using. I just boosted the RAM clocks to 3200 MHz with its default profile which was available in the BIOS. And apart from that, I really didn't do much. But because of these benchmarks, I did some changes, like I switched on the precision overboost, switched it off, turned on the auto OC and stuff like that. Now, I'm not a serious overclocker or anything. I won't even say I'm an overclocker because I've always been dependent on auto overclocking, which these motherboard vendors provide. When I first tried to do overclocking, I learned a lot from it, but it was something which does really need a lot of time, which I didn't have at the time. And I'm talking about the 2009, I guess, when I was running my system with an i7-970 processor. So it's been really long. I did some serious overclocking, but these kind of tests which I did for this video are quite interesting as what exactly the Precision Boost offers with the AMD lineup. I am running Windows 10 1903 version, which is the latest version and which comes with inbuilt Ryzen processors power plans. So the two power plans provided in Windows by default are the Ryzen Balanced and Ryzen High Performance power plans. I was not sure if changing these settings will alter any of the performance the processor is able to give us, but I didn't want to miss them because sometimes these settings do play a crucial role. But I'm sure that these settings play a more important role when you are on a laptop, and we are discussing a desktop here. But anyway, it is good to not miss what these settings have to offer. So when I ran these tests with AMD Ryzen, So when I ran these tests with AMD Balanced profile, these were some of the results. With PBO disabled, the score was 6715 at a peak temperature of 87 degrees Celsius, which is quite high, but AMD has claimed that it is okay for the processor to run at these temperatures because these are some of the temperatures which AMD knew the processor will run on. But seeing the number, many of the users throughout the world have been a little scared and in doubt that are these processors performing to their full capabilities or not. But AMD has assured everyone that it is okay for these processors to run till their limit, which is 95 degrees Celsius. But I've seen users throughout the world get proper results on their temperatures with third-party coolers, and I also plan to upgrade it soon. Now on the same settings with PBO enabled, the score is 6903 on the Cinebench R20, which is mildly impressive to the claims which AMD tried to make, and the temperature rose to 95 degrees Celsius, which is the peak temperature these processors are supposed to run. So I was a bit concerned, but there were no restarts through the system, it didn't shut off, everything was fine after the test. So I think AMD knew what they are doing with these sort of temperatures. But as I've already mentioned, a third party cooler will help you a lot. So with PBO enabled, the difference in the clocks rose approximately 2.72%, which I've already said is mildly impressive, not too much, but all these settings are in play with No, not much hassle, nothing at all. I just enabled the PBU in the BIOS and that's about it. The peak speeds with PBU enabled and with PBU disabled were around 3.9 GHz. But what is more concerning that these processors ran at 1.44 volts. So that is something which will also alarm a lot of users. But again, AMD has claimed that everything is fine. You don't need to worry about these processors running at a high voltage and a high temperature. But obviously, we would all love to see over processors perform as good as they are at a lower temperature and at a lower voltage. When I changed these power plan settings to Ryzen high performance, the scores dropped a little, which is really surprising. The text itself is saying that it is a high performance mode, and seeing the performance drop a little, it was not much, it was around 0.1 to 0.2%. But it is quite surprising that it is not supposed to drop from a balanced profile to a high performance profile. So maybe future Windows update will fix this issue. So on the high performance mode with PBU enabled, the new scores on Cinebench R20 were 6888 with PBU enabled and 6706 with PBU disabled. So just a mere 2.64% of increase in performance as compared to PBU disabled. But obviously you and me won't be using this high performance mode till Windows optimizes it more for a better performance, as the text simply says. And the voltages were again varying between 1.3 to 1.5 volts. So again, this could be concerning for some users, but I am personally okay with it because the system hasn't shown any sign of instability or restarts or reset. The peak speeds were around about the same, 3.9 GHz to 4 GHz, sometimes, not always. So now these two results were fairly similar with PBU disabled and PBU enabled. So I went to the BIOS again and switched on the auto OC feature on this Asus motherboard. So when I ran the test again, not only it gave me a higher score of 7014, on the Cinebench R20 test, the voltages also dropped. The voltages dropped to 1.1 volts and the peak speeds on all the cores rose to 4 GHz. So this is truly impressive that a motherboard BIOS and the motherboard vendor has programmed their auto OC way better than what Ryzen is offering right now with all its latest chipset updates. The peak temperatures also dropped to around 92 degrees Celsius. So clearly, enabling or disabling the PBU won't get you much higher performance ratio, which is shown by AMD in their marketing videos or on their marketing page. But there is a boost, there is a certain boost, and I'm pretty sure with the span of few months, this is only going to get better. So in conclusion, having PBU enabled with auto OC on your motherboard, if your VRMs on the motherboard are good, enable them and have the best performance the Ryzen 3000 series processors, especially the 3900X, are giving right now. It not only enabled my processors to run at a higher peak speed, it also dropped the voltages, it also dropped the temperature. So overall, I was pretty impressed with this combo. There's one more thing which you should take in account, is that the boost clock, which is 4.3 GHz, I didn't touch it on this mode, on this combination. But when the overall score on the Cinebench is going to be better, then I won't mind that. When I was rendering my projects on this processor on these settings, the time taken by the overall render, which took 7 hours on my FX8350 machine, has been dropped to 2.5 hours on this machine. So I just wanted to share in this video what kind of boost you are getting with PBU, which is being marketed heavily by AMD on the Ryzen 3000 series processor, and just let you know how much difference is it making with the balanced power plan and the high performance power plan which Windows has enabled for these processors. So if all my cores are performing better on auto OC and PBU enabled, this is the best combination I'm going to use for all my cores rather than focusing on a single core, because that's what I bought this machine for. And if I had a different requirement, if my primary requirement was gaming, then I would have definitely upgraded to a different processor, which would have been more cheaper and would have given me more value for money. That's all for today. MewBot out.